Hello everyone and welcome to another Timeless video. So today we're going to be taking a look at spirits in Timeless format. So why spirits all of a sudden? Because with the new alchemy set of Bloomboro, we got a card that is actually pretty sick for this deck. And that is called 3-Tree Battalion. So if you look at this card, there's a lot of text, but essentially, this is a collected company, but in our case, it's actually going to be better. Some cases, the collected company can be better, but most cases for this deck, the 3-Tree Battalion is actually going to be better. So collected company, on the other hand, looks at the top 6 cards, and you can put 2 creature cards with mana value 3 or less onto the battlefield. However, the 3-Tree Battalion, you look at the 6 cards, and you put a creature card with mana value 3 or less. You only choose 1 card, and then you conjure a duplicate of that card onto the battlefield. So what this essentially does, this card allows you to play deck with less creatures than a collected company. Collected company has a chance of hitting 2 creatures at a 90% if you have 30 creatures in the deck. 3-Tree Battalion has 92% chance of hitting 1 creature with only 20 creatures in the deck, which is going to be our creature count, which allows you to play this kind of a tempo shell with 20 creatures, and you have all these other instant speed and sorcery cards, which is actually sick. And especially in a shell like this, a spirit shell, if you look at Pioneer, they play collected company in a banned spirits, which was a popular deck back then. And they were only playing collected company as their green spell. So just imagine being able to play a collected company in an Azorius shell, which is what we got going on here. And one last thing to talk about this card is going back to the fact that you only need to pick 1 card and you conjure a duplicate of it. Just imagine if this card hits Supreme Phantom, it becomes 2 Supreme Phantoms. But let's say you hit a Drug Skull Captain. All of a sudden, all of your creatures become hexproof, which is actually just insane. I'm pretty excited to try this deck out. So having said that, I'll be hopping over to some Timeless Special 3 to show you guys what it does. So let's hop over. All right. I'm actually about to play some spirits, believe it or not. The Mirror Tempo? Well, this should be a good matchup. Just because they're not going to be able to counter anything if we can actually get some Cavern of Souls down here. I'm gonna go with the Sanctuary first because I have a mana drain up. It only makes sense, right? Yeah, that's actually pretty lucky. And we keep drawing Mausoleum Wanderer. What's up with that? We keep drawing Mausoleum Wanderer. That is the only card that we're drawing. Yeah, that's not where you're supposed to be as a spirit deck. That is not where you're supposed to be. I'll just sit back. I will just sit back here. I think we have to actually block. Interesting they did that. Well, hopefully there's no spell pierce. It should just be a fatal push. Nice. Super nice. Flash and Skullcrawler. Well, I'm not going to be blocking with the Supreme Phantom. Rainstorm. Opponent just had way too many Bowmasters this game. They had double Bowmasters with the, in the starting hand, and we drew literally the worst card. Triple Mausoleum Wanderer. Not to mention drawing this plane was really bad too. I could mana drain and then they mana drain and then I swords, I guess. They don't really have anything to get back after playing that, so. Yeah, this mana drain is not good. I think I might actually just play this now. There's a good chance they don't have a way to kill this thing now. Like, they would have to have exactly a fetch land in hand. Well, that's probably gonna do it. Spellqueller wouldn't have actually done it either. Nice, they got a Mistress Bauble. So next game, we try to mulligan for Cavern of Souls. I think that's it. Yeah. We try to mulligan for a Cavern of Souls. I'll take a Remorseful Cleric and an Unlicensed Hearse. Probably that's about it. Stern Scolding only gets rid of Orcish Bowmaster. Orcish Bowmaster should not be a problem. I'm gonna cut a Treasure Cruise. We do have a Cavern of Souls, so that's good. Yeah, let's get rid of that. Ooh, Rattle Chain. That's really nice. Probably not going to be flashing in this Rattle Chain here until next turn. So if I swords, they can brainstorm. I should just mana drain this, right? And then if they have a Spell Pierce, we can Swords and Rattle Chain. Or I guess they could have a Spell Snare as well, then we can still Swords here. Okay, we're drawing a lot of lands here. Still not probably gonna flash in a Rattle Chain. And keeps it on top. It was probably a land. That is good. Now we got a spell queller plus a swords. Super sick. I could spell queller that. I mean, I probably don't have to. If this was their top deck, then this is good because then they wouldn't have another fetch land, right? Demonic Tutor in the stack though, that's kind of surprising. Well, if they have a targeted removal, then they should have used it. It's probably a Bowmaster, right? Yeah, it's probably a Bowmaster. Do I want another Mana Drain at this point? Perhaps. Yeah, like, Bowmaster, who cares? If they Demonic Tutor for a Bowmaster, then it's fine, right? Let's see what they do. I really need them to like use a target removal on this spell caller though, so I can get another 2 power down. I hope opponent's hand is like all mana drains and stuff like that. That would be nice. We're drawing a lot of lands though, which is like pretty bad, which is actually pretty bad here. Opponent's kind of like stuck on lands too. So what they have currently in their hand is a Fatal Push. So they can do Orcish Bowmaster and then a Fatal Push if I block. Let's say I do block. I mana drain. I can mana drain the Fatal Push and Rattle Chain the, or I can do this. Opponent knows that I do have a mana drain in hand. Give them double Bowmasters. But then the problem is they have a Loris that I have to source later. I think I just let this stick. And then we just Rattle Chain the Spellqueller. Oh, another one. Another one! Okay, now we have 4 power on board. Which is great. We know opponent has a Fatal Push. Boom boom. I think I should be able to crack now. Now they have a sizable board. Or I could crack and then... Okay, so I know what they're trying to do. They have a Spell Snare and they're gonna Spell Snare this and we just swords. Or not. Hey. A spirit is about to win one game off of a tier 1 deck. That's not bad. Yeah, that's not bad. Toxic Deluge kills them, so if they have a Toxic Deluge, go ahead. So what are they trying to do here? They have a Toxic Deluge in hand. That's like the only way they can win at this point, right? So I probably should just let this go. They already expanded 2 mana for this, so as long as I can get 2 damage in, and they only have 3 mana open, we're good. Just counter one of the removal spell and we should be able to win. Yep. That's game. The cavern actually was so insane this game. Yeah, the cavern was so good here. I'm happy we got a game off of a tier 1 deck. I'll keep this. This hand is only really bad if they have a Tamiyo start. So hopefully they don't have a Tamiyo start. They should just take out Spell Snare or even actually Rattle Chain. Rattle Chain is a pretty big one. Also, having Drog Skull in my hand is actually kind of bad. Because that's one less card to hit with the 3 Tree Battalion. I'll take a land. Because hitting this card off of a 3 Tree Battalion is literally just game winning. It is actually just game winning. Mishra's Bauble. So I know my opponent has things like Thoughtseize. I'd rather keep my captains. I would rather keep my captains. They have a Fatal Push in the hand. I thought they made a mistake when they cracked the Mishra's Bauble last turn. Oh, that is a huge mistake I just made. Yeah, that is a huge mistake. Seacrum Coast. My one of Seacrum Coast. No way. Are we actually about to win this game? Is that what's about to happen here? Why do you have million Thoughtseizes? Why? Alright, let's see what they do. Or are they just not dead? We actually won! No way! Low risk. Low risk. Ooh, okay. Maybe I should have just played it. Because they could have an Ocelot Pride. I guess if they do, that's fine. Okay, well, we have to get rid of that. That's for sure. Meticulous Archive. I even cut another copy of Meticulous Archive, but again, we have two taplands back to back. This is literally the worst timeline. That is miserable. That is truly, truly miserable. Because I would have countered that in a heartbeat. Tough game. Because we're going second. Going second is such a scam. Yeah, when you go second in this format. Especially against an energy where literally all they play are efficient creatures. We might have survived the onslaught, so we'll see. That's insane. That's insane. Yeah, that's insane. We might have actually won the game because of that. Crazy. Crazy. I think we sit back one more turn because I really want to like Spring Phantom into Spell Snare or another 3-tree battalion. That's pretty good. Spell Quellers. I mean, let's just go with Spell Quellers just because it's a fat creature. Okay, I think we won. Yeah, I think we won. Nice. Okay, so we want some Wrath of the Skies. We also want Skyclave Apparition for sure. We don't want Flare of Denial, and we want a copy of March. I'm gonna go down on a copy of a Treasure Cruise and a Remorseful Cleric. I'm gonna take out the Mana Drains and instead have a Stern Scoldings. Although Mana Drain into this card was sick though. What to do? We're bringing in a lot of stuff. Maybe a Shacklegeist and two Mana Drains. I think I'm actually going to go down on some Mausoleum Wanderer as well. If not all of them actually. 19 creatures. That should still be 90% chance of getting a creature with a 3-3 battalion. We'll try this. I don't know. Is this good enough? Maybe. Maybe not. Surely, I mean, we're on the draw, so I'll take a hand with Wrath of the Skies. My god, we might actually have to fire this Wrath of the Skies for one. Well, yeah, we're gonna have to fire this Wrath of the Skies for one. Jesus. Maybe I should bait out Orcish Bowmaster now. If I'm gonna Wrath of the Skies here for one, I should probably just bait out Orcish Bowmaster so it has less token, right? If I draw a land, I might actually just go Droskull's Captain. I'm not sure. Yeah, we have to. Yeah, we have to. We have to. We can also get Mystic Sanctuary as well. My god. So we have successfully baited out one less damage from Orcish Bowmaster. Cydonia Nightmare. We might just be dead though, to be fair. That was so lucky that they got a Cydonia Nightmare off of that card. Why did I just do that? Oh. I'm not playing well. I think this it's a time to go to next game. I needed to play this into Wrath of the Skies. I think I need to Skyclave Apparition now. If I can find one. Spellcooler is also nice, but swords. Okay, we get some life back. And we'll try to stall with another 3-tree battalion, and then we'll grab a Wrath of the Skies. We're so low though. Yeah. Probably dead no matter what. Maybe I should have gotten rid of a Soul of Pride, but I don't know. It was just too rough. Whatever we did, we probably lost. No matter what. 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we just lost. Their start was just way too good. Double Oslo Prides, and I didn't have any removal spells. Okay. I think I'm just playing a Hallowed Fountain and pass. Monkey see, monkey do. Mana drain, yep. Guessing it's an Orcish Bowmaster here. I don't think I need that. Probably a Rattle Chain plus a Stern Scolding turn. The problem is I actually don't have anything with this mana drain. If I can find a 3-tree battalion, that would be insane. Come on.
May our axes strike as one.
Probably just get the Supreme Phantom out now. And we'll have a Rattle Chain or a Spellqueller. Interesting. Interesting. Ooh. I couldn't play the Rattle Chain because of this Bloodstained Mire. It was just not gonna happen. But on the other hand, maybe I should have made them have it. Right? Maybe I should have made them have it. Really wish we had one more mana. That would have been nice. But they actually don't have another removal spell, and I've just been tricked the entire time. Man, I would have just won the game. I need to stop playing as if they would have something. You know? I think that's my biggest mistake when piloting something like this. Like, this has to be a tempo deck, you know? I need to just keep playing stuff. It doesn't matter where I ping. If they have a 3 damage, they're gonna use it on a Supreme Phantom, so... Oh, okay, this or this? Probably just 3 battalion, right? And then I could get like a Skyclave Apparition. But then I could also get Spellqueller. Like, which one do I have to play first? I don't know. get an Orcish Bowmaster. I think I'm just going to 3-3 battalion and then miss. Oh my god. I have lost the game. Thank you very much, game. Wow. Life is not fair because we were about to win the game there. Okay. I just missed 91%. Short. Okay, the mirror tempo. Took out the rattle chain. I'll take another land. Do they actually play Spell Pierce in that deck? Nope. I think I'm just going to Treasure Cruise here. Hmm. Didn't get what I wanted. Did not get what I wanted. Was not able to get what I wanted there. If it's a Bowmaster, I could just Flare Up Denial using the Mausoleum Wanderer, but I think this is okay. This is also okay as well. I think I just have to let this stick. I can't like just sacrifice a 3-mana creature and a Flare of Denial for a Rainstorm just to deny Tamio.
In the right hand, knowledge is the sharpest blade.
Man, where's our Source of Plowshare? Rattle chain. Yeah, we drew a little bit too many lands this game, didn't we?
Aggression is unbecoming.
Just a tiny bit. Well, at least we know what they're about to draw next turn, so that's good.
Think before you.
Where's our Cavern of Souls, though? That is just upsetting. I'm actually surprised they did this. They filled up the graveyard for me. there any swords in the graveyard? Nope. Crazy. Why did you tap? God, I hate this game so much sometimes. I hate this game so much sometimes. I could get a Shackle Geist, but I think it's just Supreme Phantom at this point.
I wanted to trust you.
Now, I'm not sure if they have another Drown in the Lock here, but hopefully they don't. They're gonna Treasure Cruise first before attacking. We also have a Flare of Denial here, so I feel kind of safe, you know? Isn't this crazy what they did? I'm not taking like crazy pills here, right? I mean, yes, we do lose out on... How good is this Treasure Cruise, really? If I Flare of Denial, I have to block the Nethergoyf. So essentially, I'll be losing two. Man, this is actually a hard, tough call. Goes to four. I have to double block this, right? I think I have to give them a Treasure Cruise. If they have a Fatal Push, I lose the game. An okay outcome. So they knew about this, huh? I can Flare of Denial, so... Maybe I should have attacked first. Fatal Push. Is it actually Spell Pierce? Like, everything just kind of points to Spell Pierce at this point. Okay, that's insane. Are they dead?
Violence is not the answer.
They are super dead. I don't need to use this Flare of Denial except for exactly double Orcish Bowmasters. Because them drawing a card here is just so bad. Removal spell doesn't work, counter spell doesn't work, so the only card that I'm kind of worried about is Orcish Bowmaster at that point. Yeah, we want a Hearse and a Cleric. I might actually want some Skyclave Apparitions. They play a lot of creatures and Stern Scoldings as well. We don't want Shackle Geist. Do we actually? They have a Frog. As much as I like Mausoleum Wanderer, going second with this card is so bad. I'll probably cut a Treasure Cruise as well, just because like I feel like our deck is kind of hard dealing with the Bowmasters. Yeah, I'm actually just going to cut Skyclave Apparitions. Let's also go down on a copy of Mausoleum Wanderer. Kind of a tough hand. This one looks a lot better. Swords, Supreme Phantom. I think I'm going to go down on a Flare here. The opponent's looking for a land, and what they drew is probably a land there. Maybe I shouldn't have actually sourced that. Oh man, I shouldn't have sourced that. Because of Psychic Frog. Yeah. What a gigantic mistake. What an awful mistake. That was such a bad mistake. I forgot about the Psychic Frog. Big sad. That was a huge misplay there. Like an astronomically huge misplay. They have to discard three cards for this. That has to be worth it, right? That has to be worth it. This has to be super worth it. Is that really what they had? They had to have a mana drain somewhere, right? And the last card is the Orcish Bowmaster. Darn. So I should have cracked this first and then mana drained. What is this? Like, they just play only creatures or something? Okay, that's actually really good. That is actually so good. Block, block. And then sacrifice. Remorseful Cleric. They can't really attack with a Nethergoyf. Okay, let's crack this. Mana Drain? Sure. We get a Spell Queller plus a Spell Snare. I think I have to let this through. We're like a 3-tree battalion away from winning the game. All right, last card is a 2-mana spell. Perfect. I can't really attack because of the Nyssen's Hearse. Maybe I can attack. Let's see. Okay, let's say I attack with the Remorseful Cleric. Spring Phantom blocks the Psychic Frog. I deal 6 here. Then next turn I win the game. But then I have to sacrifice the Remorseful Cleric if I make that play though. So I guess I just attack the Remorseful Cleric. Tough game. We need to draw a spirit. I think Opponent messed up by not using the unlicensed curse on their own creature. I mean, own graveyard. Come on. Beautiful top deck? That's an interesting card. Opponent takes 6, go to 4, and then I sacrifice Remorseful Cleric. Attack with the Spell Queller. All right. They discarded a Treasure Cruise. Isn't that insane? Okay. Potentially a last turn. Potentially a last turn. I made some gambles here. We'll see. Can pay for Spell Pierce as well. Come on. Let's see it. The most beautiful card off the top. Darn. No way. That's such a sad way to go. I feel like this has been happening a lot. Like, even that last game against the Boros Energy, we really shouldn't have lost that game, you know? But the 3-tree battalion missing. And here we drew 3 lands in a row, so we lost the game as well. It seems like the deck just kind of feels like we're just missing that last push to win the game here. Oh god, I mean, I love Cavern of Souls, but that's a bit much, you know? No, thank you. Rattle Chain. That's our first Cavern of Souls. Isn't that insane?
If you need me, I'll be in the library.
Skyclave Apparition off the top? No? Okay. Such a dangerous attack. Shacklegeist. Orcish Bowmaster. I don't know how many copies of a Fiddle Push they have. Hopefully they don't have another Fiddle Push. Nice. Interesting. Toxic Deluge. I forgot, did they shock this in? Pretty good. Oh, that's actually an expensive treasure cruise. Holy moly. That is a huge treasure cruise. I might just rattle chain here. Let's see what they do. Very nice. And we'll spell caller next turn. Ooh. I guess spell caller is better, right? Or should I Supreme Phantom Mausoleum Wanderer here? Like, forget about the... Yeah, let's just Supreme Phantom as a Mausoleum Wanderer. Very nice. Alright, so we played 5 games. We went 3-2, losing to a Jesse Control, plus losing to an energy deck, as you've seen from my game. And this card was actually surprisingly insane. We're only playing 3 copies of it because it is a pretty clunky card if you don't hit it off of a 3-tree battalion. So we're only playing 3 copies of it, but I can definitely see myself playing 4 copies just because hitting this card off of a 3-tree battalion is almost game-winning. So yeah, this card is pretty insane. The fact that this deck, right, Azorius Spirit doesn't have to splash a green color, absolutely bonkers. And the fact that this card doesn't require you to play like 30 creature deck is also another huge boon for this deck, right? The fact that this card can hit Supreme Phantoms or Drug Skull Captain is absolutely insane. Sometimes hitting the Spell Queller is cute, but downside of hitting something like a Spell Queller, second Spell Queller that it conjures onto the battlefield doesn't really do anything. Conjuring a Rattle Chain is pretty good. I would say conjuring a Shacklegeist is also decent. Conjuring a Mausoleum Wander is actually insane. And I also changed the mana base a little bit just because I've been having an issue of getting multiple tap lands before turn 3. So yeah, that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye-bye.